Hi, hello, good morning everyone. Abhishek here, back in with another video, and today is first day of Hemal Summer School 23. So I'm totally excited for this. And today I got this email. It is going to be 30 minute session. They will going to share what all we can expect from this webinars and all. So this is the link of the webinar, and today they are going to cover supervised learning. It is going to be from 9:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. the classes will be, and after this there is going to be a Q&A session. Industry experts will be sharing things and we can ask them questions. I'm totally excited for this new journey, and let's see what all they are going to bring on the table. And stay connected, I'm going to share everything with you. Stay connected. So it is almost 9. Let's join the webinar. So this is going to conduct on this Go webinar website. Still 2 minutes is left.
Hey, hi everyone. Good morning. Hope all of you have having a great day. I'm Anu, part of the organizing team of Amazon ML Summer School. And here to welcome you all to the third edition of the event. So before starting, let me take a minute to quickly introduce myself. So I'm senior manager with international machine learning team at Amazon. I started my journey with Amazon more than 8 years back. Started with building contact forecasting models for worldwide marketplaces before moving to my current role that focuses on managing markets for Amazon. Now I'm leading an applied science team working in the areas of customer abuse prevention, product bundle recommendation, address quality improvement, and attribute, and talk about format of the program. So Amazon ML Summer School aims to provide you with best-in-class training on a broad range of topics which are at the core of modern machine learning. So they range from fundamentals to state of the art. So when we started conceptualizing the program back in 2021, the idea was not just to talk about few concepts in ML or latest advancements, but also augment them with a practical industry perspective. So you'll find out about exciting possibilities surrounding the use of ML in solving real world applications. You'll get a flavor of practically how we can use some of these concepts and how we have been using them at Amazon. Their domain over years of experience. And you'll also get an opportunity to interact with them during the live Q&A sessions. So here you can ask your queries and learn from their experience. So yeah, overall the core idea of the program is to help foster ML excellence and strive towards developing applied science skills of young talent. So as part of ML Summer School,
So just done with welcome introduction. Let me summarize it for you. So he told that the classes will be conducted by industry experts, and we can ask doubts from ML scientists about whatever doubt we have. To get fair chances, they are going to split the batches into slots, and we can ask questions. So these many topics they are going to cover: supervised learning, deep learning, dimensional reduction, casual interface, many things they are going to cover. And see, scientists will explain the concepts during the Q&A. 1 hour session it will be. So pretty promising. Let's see how will be the experience, and waiting for the first class today.
Oops. To the outputs that we want to predict.
This is a class label or class probability.
So done with the first session, this is the second session. First session was pretty basic about overfitting, underfitting and all. So let's continue the course.
It was actually that, okay, what is the age of the person? So the age, and you find that as point C.
So done with the first session, it was pretty basic about linear regression, underfitting and overfitting. So this is based on decision trees. So let's continue
with the course. What is the weighted Gini impurity of each of them?
So instructor is really good going through all the basics do the decent one formulas and I'll see.
No.
So done with second session. Third session will start in within 12 minutes. He covered topics like decision tree, assemble learning, bagging and boosting, ADA boosting, gradient boosting. So he covered with the examples, when should we use which algorithm and which is more better and what are the trade-off we have to look for to use these algorithms. It was good session and let's wait for third one. Oh, done with second session. Third will start in within at 8 minutes. So they're covering all the topics. One of the thing I am missing is hands-on session. There is no coding part and something. They are just going through the theory or math behind it and what are the trade-offs you have to do using that algorithm. So the course is really nice. Even they're starting from the beginning to intermediate. They're not going in advance. This was refreshing for me because I have done my ML course in my MCA. So yeah, really good course or really good instructor. Just I'm missing coding part. Third session start over.
Hello everyone, my name is Mayank Sharma and I'm an applied scientist at Amazon Prime Video International Expansion Team. Welcome to the third lecture in the Supervised Learning module. So today I shall be discussing some of the evaluation metrics and supplementary topics in supervised learning. The order of the presentation will be as follows. We'll discuss some of the evaluation metrics which are typically used for classification and regression tasks. We'll talk about how multi-class classification is performed. We'll talk about some of the classifiers which are typically used, such as naive Bayes classifier, k-nearest neighbor classifier, support vector machine classifier. And then we'll finally talk about how do you perform model selection.
Okay, this is very interesting.
As I said, one metric might not be always appropriate. It depends on the business objective. You need to retrain the model periodically because there might be data drift. Because let's say people would buy different kind of clothes in summer versus winter, right? So a model which is trained for summer clothes won't work for the winter clothes. You need to retrain it depending on the time of the year, right? And we should also ensure the training data distribution is in sync with the test data distribution. If the distribution of the two are different, the model will obviously fail, right? So these are some of the modeling tips I'd like to leave you with. And that's it from my side. And I'll leave it open for the questions.
Okay, after the break, the Q&A session will start. Let me give the feedback to them. Guys, it is already 4. Let's start the Q&A session.
Hello everyone. First question, can everybody hear me? Can somebody post it on the chat that I'm audible?
Hey man, I can hear you.
Okay, cool. So hello everyone, my name is Maya. I'm a senior applied scientist in Prime Video Content Localization and Accessibility Org. I primarily work in audio and natural language processing domain. I've been in Amazon for past 5 years in the same team. What my team does is effectively does localization of the Prime Video content. For example, let's say there is a Korean content and you want to watch it in India. Typically, most of us do not understand Korean, so we rely on subtitles. Sanjay, over to you.
Hey, hi, Meg. Thank you. So, hello, everyone. This is Sanjay. I'm an applied scientist.
I cannot mute here.
So, we have been primarily working on sponsored ads. So, I mean, in Amazon, when you type a query in, like on this Amazon portal, you see some results on search phase, where some of them are organic or some of them are sponsored ads only. So, what is sponsored ads? Using sponsored ads, sellers can advertise their listing on Amazon where there's some cost associated for each of the clicks, and that cost is called CPC, which generates revenue for the company. So, So using these sponsor ads, our primary objective is to increase revenue, increase product coverage, showing the more relevant ads. Like for this, we have been working on building many machine learning based models using which we can fetch highly relevant ads, and we'll have more, like if we have more and more clicks, we'll have more revenue. And yeah, so this is what I have been working on in Amazon.
Yeah, thank you, Sanjay. The way we will operate this Q&A session is you guys can start posting the questions and we'll start answering them both in chat and try to answer them verbally. The session would be of 45 minutes. And prior to starting of the session, you can start posting the questions. There are some questions which are very common, which comes out very often. We'd like to answer those first. These are some of the non-technical questions which many of you guys have. So one of them is, will there be any internship opportunity given post this program? So effectively, Amazon will reach out to you for any internship opportunity based on the business requirements. And then there are questions related to, will I get any certification of the program? So effectively, you guys will get an acknowledgement letter. Post completion of the program, will there be hiring? Will the hiring process be different for ML Summer School participants? So hiring process would remain the same as per the applied role. And will there be any recordings which would be shared? Yes, the recordings would be shared. And for any other email, for any other queries which you may have, non-technical queries, you please write an email to mlsummerschool@amazon.com. So I'll paste this in chat window. So this is the link, mlsummerschool@amazon.com. That's the mail ID. So yeah, Sanjay, over to you. Do you want to start answering some of these questions with from our audience?
Okay, so I'll start like reading the question, like from Shonak Gupta. So in linear regression, why the cost function is quadratic?
So basically speech and audio processing, where you find out where the voices are and try to increase those volume. Similarly, in subtitle translation, right, you use machine learning and neural machine translation models, which essentially translate your subtitle from language A to language B, right? And similarly for video processing as well, right? Let's say you want to place ads somewhere in the movie, right? So you need to identify where a scene starts and where a scene ends, right? Similarly, ads should not be placed in places where there is dialogues happening. If two people are conversing, you should not place an ad there. It should be placed post that. So all these kinds of research, audio, video, and textual processing, and even a multimodal kind of a processing research is happening in Prime Video. Similarly, you want to encode those, in some cases even terabytes, right? You want to reduce the size of them. So you essentially encode into lower size, right? So all that research goes on in Prime Video to make sure the content reaches our customer very quickly and is of very high quality.
Can you, basically to use to, basically to divide the root node, or let's say any node, into the left and right nodes. So how do we calculate Gini value? Is basically the formula is 1 minus summation of p c square, where p is the probability of a particular class, I mean the number of samples, divided by the total number of samples. You take this formula, calculate the Gini value for the node, and then you calculate the Gini value for right node and left node, and then you get the information B. So depending on which feature or the value for that particular feature is giving you the most information gain, I mean, you take that feature and that particular value. Not fixed in Amazon.
Let
I
me
mean,
go through all of
team,
this
or
questions.
What sort of problems you would be working on, I mean the problems will differ and even the techniques will differ. So I mean, yeah, that's the case. So I'll just move on to the next question. What is convex function and convex concave function? So convex function is basically, so here in case of machine learning, we basically, when we try to find a local minima, global minima, we consider those as a convex function. We want our loss function to be a convex function because this is where you can minimize the loss function. While in case of convex concave function,
if I understand correctly, so this is just ML summer school and not internship. It's answering the question from Mohammed Anas Khan, if I'm pronouncing it correctly. You can apply for internships through Amazon job portals. Maybe I'll add the link in the answer. You can apply for internship here. Sanjay, over to you.
There's so many, on YouTube, or like there's so many courses on Udemy, Coursera. You can reach out, you can take any courses from there. And there's some lectures from Andrew NG, which are open source on YouTube itself. You can go through those. And apart from that, if you want to do hands-on, you can go to Kaggle. You have lots of data. There are codes which are open source, like other researchers also. So, there's so much of material which is already available, and you can start practicing from there. You'll have to look into the code. You are not doing any sort of.
Guys, sadly, I couldn't record or see last part of the Q&A session, because some placement thing happened in my college. I'm so sorry for that. To summarize this session, it was really, really insightful. The Q&A session, they were actually helping each and every questions. Even my question was answered at the last. I saw it. So they have told that the recordings will be shared with us. Let's wait for it. I'll go through chats again, and if I get the access, I'll upload. So thank you so much for watching this video. I will be making second day video and whole journey video on this. So lot of Q&A section was there. If I'll get, I'll upload it.